At the festival of Candlemas, we celebrate the presentation of Christ in the temple and the purification of the Virgin Mary. What does all that mean? Well, in ancient Jewish law, based on Leviticus, a new mother wasn't allowed to enter the temple until 40 days after the birth of her son, or 60 days after birth of a daughter. And the parents had to bring a sacrificial offering of a lamb to the entrance of the temple. Or if they were poor, like Joseph and Mary, they could bring a pair of turtle doves or pigeons. Luke's gospel tells us that when Joseph and Mary brought the infant Jesus to the temple, they met two elderly, devout people. Anna, a prophetess, and we'll hear more about her later on, and Simeon. Simeon had been told by God that he wouldn't die before he saw the Messiah. The Spirit led him to the temple, and when he saw Jesus, he took him in his arms and he praised God, saying a special prayer which we now call the Nunc Dimittis, which includes the words, "I have seen with my own eyes a light that will bring revelation to the Gentiles." And this gives us a strong image of Jesus as the light of the world. Now, because we celebrate Christmas on December the 25th, 40 days after brings us to February the 2nd. And just as Christmas is linked with Yuletide, so Candlemas is bolted on to the pagan festival of light. It marks the midpoint between the shortest day and the spring equinox. It's the beginning of the lambing season. And a bit like St. Swithin's Day, the weather on Candlemas Day is said to predict the weather to come. If Candlemas Day be fair and bright, winter will have another fight. If Candlemas Day bring cloud and rain, go winter and come not again. So hope for a rainy Candlemas. In church tradition, candles which are going to be used during the year are blessed and brought into the church. Many people used to light candles in their houses in the windowsills. And it's a good time for us to celebrate Jesus, the light of the world, during this dark time of year.
Thank you. Almighty and ever-living God, clothed in majesty, whose beloved Son was this day presented in the temple in substance of our flesh, grant that we may be presented to you with pure and clean hearts by your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen.
When the time came for the purification rites required by the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the Lord required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people, Israel." The child's father and mother marvelled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Penuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was very old, and she lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then was a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. When Joseph and Mary had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong. He was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was on him.
Thank you. Today we are celebrating the festival of Candlemas, when Mary and Joseph took the baby Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem to dedicate him to God's service. This is the story of the prophetess Anna, who is so excited by what she sees that she becomes one of the first evangelists of the Bible. Anna was unstoppable. Most people, when they reach their 80s, are often great grandparents and are about ready to put their feet up, to take things a bit easier and let others do the rushing about and the worrying, but not Anna. Nothing seemed too much trouble for Anna. She was unstoppable. She was as busy serving God and his people at 84 years old as she had been at 24. The temple in Jerusalem was the centre of her life. It wasn't just the services where morning and evening, rain or shine, she was always there in the front row, singing and praying her heart out, but she was also there for all the routine temple jobs. She did the cleaning, she fetched water for thirsty travellers, she welcomed people at the door so well that no one ever felt a stranger. She was always ready with a smile, a kind word for the lonely, or a special prayer for those in trouble. They called her the prophetess, and that was quite an honour in those days. Very few women in history had been given such a special title. Anna was unstoppable, but she had a special secret too. From time to time, she shared it with those who were ready to listen. You see, when she was praying, singing, welcoming, fetching water, cleaning and caring for others, she was also doing something else. She was on the lookout. She was waiting for God's promised rescuer, the one that God said would come to sort out the mess of the world. She was sure she was going to meet him one day, although time was ticking on for Anna. It was a very ordinary morning when something extraordinary happened. A young couple arrived with their 6-week-old baby for a special thank you service. Anna, as usual, was unstoppable, handing out the books, smiling to the worshippers and welcoming new visitors. But when she saw this couple, and in particular this baby boy, she thought there was something special about him. But what was it? By the time she went into the service to join with everyone for the celebration, she saw a most amazing thing. The baby was no longer in the arms of his mother, but had been picked up by a friendly elderly man. She knew him because he often visited the temple. Younger than her, but even so a granddad in his own right. But that wasn't the most remarkable thing. This granddad was singing, a singing granddad. For once, the unstoppable Anna was stopped in her tracks. Grandad Simeon, for that was his name, was singing about the baby. Now I can go in peace and my long waiting cease. God's rescuer has come, a light for everyone. Anna gazed open-mouthed. There had been something special about this baby. This was the one she'd been waiting for, God's special rescuer. God's special light for the world. A baby. Of course, how like God to take them all by surprise. Anna was so excited that she'd finally met the one she'd been waiting for, the baby Jesus. He was the light of the world. And of course, Anna could not contain herself. She told everyone about it. She told the people who came to the temple doors. She told the people who drank the water. She told the people she prayed with on the temple steps. She told the people with whom she cleaned the temple ornaments. Because of Prophetess Anna, lots of people got to hear about Jesus, the light of the world. Anna was unstoppable, and so it turned out, was the light that was Jesus. Jesus is like a light that shows us the way, a light that brings deep joy into our lives, a light that brings comfort, reassurance and hope. But it's not the whole picture. Jesus's light is also a warning light, a challenging light, a light that warns us that we have to be ready to change. The world is not as God wants it to be. We are not the people God wants us to be. Jesus's light challenges us, warns us that we have to be ready for change, and then work with him to make our world more like the kingdom of God. Amen. Let us pray to God, who alone makes us dwell in safety. Almighty God, we give thanks for the welcome given to the child Jesus by Simeon and Anna, seeing that in his life there would be joy, sorrow and suffering, and for the example they have set us. As we remember the older and retired people in our churches, we thank you and pray for their work with children, young people and families in our communities. We pray your Holy Spirit may inspire them to use and share their experiences of life with wisdom, humility, and gladness. Jesus, light of the world, shine in our darkness. We pray for the world's nations and leaders, and for those who are guiding our nation and shaping national policies at this challenging time, that they may make wise decisions. Jesus, light of the world, shine in our darkness. At this time when so many have died of COVID, we pray for the vulnerable and the fearful, for the gravely ill and the dying, that they may know your comfort and peace. Lord, we pray for those who have died and those who miss and grieve for them. We pray for all who are affected by coronavirus through illness or isolation or anxiety, that they may find relief and recovery. We pray for doctors, nurses, and medical researchers sacrificially working to bring aid and help where it is most needed. We pray that through their skill and insights, many will be restored to health. Jesus, light of the world, shine in our darkness. Jesus Christ is the light of the world, a light which no darkness can quench. We light a candle as a symbol of your love and warmth and hope. You turn our darkness into light. In your light shall we see light. Grant us and all who have known you in their hearts a share in your eternal kingdom. Jesus, light of the world, shine in our darkness. In the silence of these moments, we make our particular concerns known to God. Jesus, light of the world, shine in our darkness. Open our eyes, Father, to the light of your glory in the world you have made, in the people around us, and in the face of Jesus Christ, our Lord. We commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Let us say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Children have such a disarming way about them, and when they sing, there's just nothing like it. Our South African Christmas celebration would not have been complete without the pure, sweet voices of the African Children's Choir. These choirs of African children have let their little light shine all over the world for more than 20 years as they have served as ambassadors for their homeland. Their joy and energy was contagious.